Just listen to the bell until the sound, just follow the sound to the end. Great, and now bring yourself into a comfortable seat. You can sit on the floor as I am. You can put a pillow underneath you, and you can definitely sit in a chair. If you're in a chair, I'd like for you to sit on the edge of the seat with your feet flat on the ground and your knees and ankles kind of stacked on top of each other and reaching tall and up through the spine. Okay, so we really want an upright spine. Sometimes we don't know what to do with the hands, whether you're sitting in a chair or on the floor. So a good way to deal with that is please lift up your arms and bring your elbows into the waist and then just drop the hands here. So you can allow the shoulders to drop. You can take them up to your ears, back, and then slide the shoulder blades down the back. Okay, and if you need to redo the arms again one more time from that position, there you are. All right, and this is fine. Just like this. Again, just bring your focus in. Let's follow a cycle of breath, a big inhale through the nose, and an exhale right here. So the phrases that we're going to offer are about safety, happiness, health, and ease. And we're gonna work through various targets, starting more personal, working our way to a wider and wider target, okay? Now we start with offering these phrases to ourself. And you know what? When I did this for the first time, it was really hard. I can definitely do it now, but when I first learned this practice, maybe 15 years ago, I could not offer loving kindness to myself. So if you feel that way right now, what I was taught to do was to bring someone close to me, like my husband or your partner or your teacher or your someone you love, right? You know, could be a mother or a father, could be your animal, but have them sitting right across from you, facing you, and having them offer the phrases to you. Okay, so play with that in this first round. So this is how it goes. Offering the practices to the self. This is the first target. May I be safe. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I live with ease. So that's the first target. And we'll practice that for about 1 minute. And then we'll move on to the next one. 1 to 2 minutes, and then we'll move on to the next target. So you can start saying the phrases out loud, and when that feels like it feels a little bit forced, you can become silent and offer the phrases silently until I ring the bell, and then we'll move on to the next target. So practice along with me. May I be safe. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I live with ease. May I be safe. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I live with ease. May I be safe. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I live with ease. May I be safe. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I live with ease. May I be safe. May I be happy. May I be healthy. May I live with ease. And keep going here. If you find your mind roaming or getting distracted, no problem. Just come back to the phrases. Happens to everyone. May I be safe. Be healthy, live with ease. You don't need to feel a big feeling. The feeling, the outcome, it's a benefit, it's the product of the practice. You don't have to feel anything particular. the practice does it itself without you. A few more rounds here, may I be safe, happy, healthy, live with ease. Okay, let's move to the second target, which is offering these phrases to a teacher or a guide or a benefactor. And this practice has already put one of my dogs to sleep. So if you hear some snoring in the background, it's one of my dogs meditating with us. It's Gopi. Let's offer the practice here. So if you could, please bring to mind a teacher or a guide, okay? And really see them, really bring them there. You can allow your eyes to fall closed right here and really see the person, whether they're in the body or out of the body, really bring them here, see them, and offer the phrases to them. And we do that like this. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. Continue to say it out loud if that feels right, or if it starts to feel forced, just allow yourself to be silent with the phrases. Really seeing that person right in front of you. You don't need to feel anything. And if you've wandered away, bring your attention right back. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. The third target is we're going to offer these phrases to a family member or a close friend. So now bring your awareness, really find that person, bring them right in front of you, and you're going to offer those phrases to them. You see how this works? We're moving from the very close to ourselves to someone who's been super meaningful to us, a close teacher or guide. And now we're moving to a family member or close friend that we would naturally feel comfortable, like, because we love them, right? It's easy to offer them the phrases, okay? So let's do that. And you can name the person here if you want to, if that's helpful. Alicia, I'll bring her here. Alicia, may you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. Alicia, may you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. notice your mind wandering away, just gently come back to the phrases. And my teacher would say, one of my heroes, Sharon Salzberg, who I learned this practice from, she has a book called Loving Kindness. She would ask us in session to just gently come back to the practice without piling on, she says, without adding, oh God, look what you did. You're like, you know, such a bad meditator and you're never gonna get this. That's kind of piling on. Just see if we can drop that. Just come back to the phrases. May you be safe, Alicia. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. Really see them. Bring them right in front of you. Offer them the phrases. So the next target is what we call the neutral person or an acquaintance. And again, when I was studying this, my teacher would tell a story about offering this to the person in the grocery store. And so, you know, I did the same thing. And actually this person, so it should be somebody you don't know. So you see how we're kind of expanding our field of well-being and kindness and openness, acceptance. We're spreading the net even further. So I went to the grocery store and I decided I picked a person there. And I mean, this is exactly the same story I heard from my teacher, but it's the same teacher, and maybe you'll choose the same story and be teaching this to your friends and community at some point. But so I picked the person at the Ingles and started offering her loving kindness. And now when I'm at the store, I look for her and I try to go to her aisle. And then I'm like putting my stuff out and I'm like looking at her and just like feeling such a connection with her. And it's just such a sweetness to it. You know, she has no idea, but I'm like, how are you? and it's my own, coming from my own beautiful heart, cultivating the feeling state of generosity and kindness and love. And it's a beautiful mind state, heart state to be, and which is a healing state, kind of circling back to, you know, really what we're doing here together is healing. It's where health meets consciousness, right? So see if you can find a neutral person, someone you kind of see on a regular basis. Could be an acquaintance, somebody you don't know. Could be the person that delivers your mail. I actually used him for a while. And really, I did. I started to wonder if he's married and started thinking about his kids and, you know, should give him a better Christmas bonus, you know, just like that, you know. So take that moment. See if you can bring that person right in front of you. Could be the FedEx person. Could be the, you know, just anybody, the friend of the friend. Bring that person. It's really a big piece of this is really to try to bring them here in your mind's eye, right in front of you, and offer the practice. They don't need to respond or anything like that, but I'd love for you to feel that kind of connection with that person. Okay? So if you got them, if you see them, let's begin to offer them the phrases. I'm going to use my friend at the grocery store. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. So again, if your mind has wandered off, just bring it back. And it's natural to have a little bit of difficulty making a connection because you don't have a connection with this person. So if you're noticing that feeling a little bit, no problem. You're getting there. It's kind of what we're doing. And we're cultivating that opportunity to build more connection and more connection as part of our own set point. All right, so bring that person focus in and again, restart the phrases. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. Let them continue as a silent meditation. See them here. Continue the phrases. Okay, next, this next target is called the difficult person or the enemy. Now, we don't want to go for the most difficult person you've ever encountered in your whole life. You know, someone who traumatized you. That's not what we're aiming for. I mean, you may get there, but just even somebody you have a little bit of tension with right now, that you have something, just a little bit of an unsettled issue with, you know, starting to really not otherize people. Like, oh, these are all the people I care about and these are all the people I don't care about, right? So seeing if you can close in that gap, starting with someone maybe you have had like some words with or some difficulty with, but overall you still, you know, are in your circle and care about, all right? And then this becomes a practice of widening that, closing the gap. I mean, after all, a premise of our work with Chinese medicine is everything is all connected. Everything is one, included inside that circle of the Tao. So really finding a way toward acceptance of what has happened, where you are now, and how you want to be moving forward, how you want to be relating to your life and to people and to your experiences moving forward. Okay, so bring that experience, that process, or that person into your presence right in front of you. Bring it to mind. If it's an experience, just give it a label. You know, that difficult experience. Just to, like, bring that here and put it right in front of you. So the phrase here will be, may you be safe, may you be happy, may you be healthy, may you live with ease, or may it be safe, may it be happy, may it be healthy, may it flow or be with ease. Okay, may you be safe, may you be happy, may you be healthy. May you live with ease. May it be safe. May it be happy. May it be healthy. May it live with ease. May it be safe. May it be happy. May it be healthy. May it live with ease. May it be safe. May it be happy. May it be healthy. May it live with ease. May it be safe. May it be happy. May it be healthy. May it live with ease. May it be safe. May it be happy. May it be healthy. May it live with ease. Safe, happy, healthy, and live with ease. Again, presencing, follow the sound to its end. So the last target that we'll use today is just to widen our field of friendliness, of loving kindness, to all beings everywhere. So sometimes that's hard to connect with, so we can start to use opposites, right? Like, you know, all beings inside this room and then outside this room, all beings inside my neighborhood and beyond my neighborhood. So you can start to work the inside my state and all of the states. So that's a way you can start to widen that frame and generalize it out more and more and more. So if you struggle to connect with it, like all beings everywhere, you can start more slowly like that. But bring that feeling tone to, and bring that right in front of you. Maybe you see the globe. Maybe you imagine people everywhere holding hands across the whole planet. So bring that feeling tone or that visual right in front of you. And this will be our final target. May all beings be safe. May all beings be happy. May all beings be healthy. May all beings live with ease. May all beings be safe. May all beings be happy. May all beings be healthy. May all beings live with ease. May all beings be safe. May all beings be happy. May all beings be healthy. May all beings live with ease. May all beings be safe. May all beings be happy. May all beings be healthy. May all beings live with ease. Right? And if your mind wanders off, bring it right back here. And all beings here includes our animal friends, the ones that are big, the ones that are small, the ones that are microscopic. All beings, a friendliness towards those beings that we even are a little bit scared of, wasps and ants and just everything else. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. May you be safe. May you be happy. May you be healthy. May you live with ease. And when that starts, the voice starts to feel forced, let that trail off. May all beings be safe. May all beings be happy. May all beings everywhere be healthy. May all beings everywhere live with ease. And follow the sound to the end. So thank you so much for sharing this practice with me. I hope it serves the highest in you and all those that you touch. Thank you again for being here. Namaste.